Good evening.
Tonight we celebrate the sixth Sunday of Easter. Please rise for our opening song gathering.
Your spirit.
We pause now to begin our sacramental celebration. We ask God's mercy and forgiveness for our community. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us and give us our sins and bring us to life and everlasting.
Amen.
Thank you.
Almighty God, that we may celebrate the heartfelt devotion these days of Easter joy, to seek peace and honor of the risen Lord. And that what we live in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
When Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up, I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." While Peter was still speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured out on the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit even as we have?" He ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, let us love one another, because love is of God. Everyone who loves is begotten by God and knows God. Whoever is without love does not know God, for God is love. In this way, the love of God was revealed to us. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love, not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, as the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remained in his love. I told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy might be in me. This is my command, love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend. You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. This I command you, love one another. The Gospel.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Chosen us before we even realize what has happened. gift of life. Give us the gift of faith. We have been chosen to share this life. And Jesus tells his disciples, it is not you who chose me, but I chose you. The same power to be my desire. It is a great moment of realization that we have been given much without honor, earning it, meriting it, in any way. We have been given life, love, support. And we didn't have to do anything to earn that. You know, how many people I think go through life, somehow trying to earn God's love, or to earn even the love of their parents? And what they don't realize that love is very, very important to them. Freedom. But God is love. Love is not something God does, but God is. It is what God is. The Father's love has been dramatically expressed in the Son's love for us. And the interaction of the Father and the Son resulted from the person of the Holy Spirit, who lives also in us. So if we don't earn God's love, then what do we need to do? And I think in the scriptures this evening, we are asked by Jesus to share that love with others. In fact, he says it is necessary to share God's love if we want to remain in His love. Do what I command you, and remain in my love. And this command, this great command, is love one another, as I have given you. And so the mission of the saints and all of us is to live in saints for others, to lay down our life for others as Jesus did for us. Peter, in that first reading, realizes this, and he could not help but share the good news that Jesus saw that was within them. And because he shared that, he received from Julius and all his household new baptism into God. The church is outward bound. And that's what Jesus said, go out into the world and bring the good news. It's time to take the love that Jesus gave us and bring it to the world. And Mother's Day is a good day to reflect on this, because the love of a mother for her child is so much like the love of God for each one of us. We receive without merit. We bask in this, in our innocence, and we are challenged to imitate that tonight as we come to mature. And I think that in many ways, you know, in many languages, my mother, many years ago, but I think of things that she did that when I first come to realization of this, and I look back and even they marvel at the some events that she took from the woodburning stove. Not once, but week after week, year after year, she had the gift of knowing very, very quick. And to think that she did all of that. Get all of our laundry without the use of them. Things that are automatic for us, they're sculptures and dryers. And on the clothes and clothing, she took care of and you don't realize until much later, how much your sacrifice has been. And probably, I think one of the best gifts that you can give our elders is to let her know by how we live our lives and what we do, to let her know we have become, in some fashion, the same kind of loving person that she was. And that's exactly what God is asking of us. I think God rejoices in us when we can imitate his love. Behind the hands and the feet and the voice and the touch of Jesus. It's not a down payment on that, but it should be a reflection and a response to that love that we did earn and give. Well, it's a great study now of the profession of faith and the opportunity. I believe in God.
The Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
May your love inspire Pope Francis and all church leaders and increase vocations to the priesthood, religious life, and lay church ministry. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Raise up your love, O God, in nations where governments oppress and terrorize their own people. May all who hunger for freedom and justice be satisfied. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers whose lives we celebrate and honor today, our own mothers who brought us into life, and for those women who have mothered us along the way, may they be blessed and honored every day. And may our society hold the vocation of motherhood in the highest esteem. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May your love give hope to the suffering, those in nursing homes, hospitals, and mental institutions, and those undergoing prolonged medical treatment. May all be brought to health and wholeness through the mercy of Christ and the ministry of his disciples. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May your love raise up our beloved dead and bring them to a glorious life. Especially remember our deceased mothers and grandmothers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal intentions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord God, we ask you to watch over us this day. Help us to do and say the things that know you but your God. As we make this prayer, we pray our
Amen. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrifice of offering, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed to the mysteries of the Almighty God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to complain to you, O Lord. But at this time, above all, praise to you, O Lord, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. You have the children of life, rise from eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are grown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom to death. And in his rising, the light of all is therefore, overcome with acts of God, every land, every people, exalts in your faith, and even the heavenly powers will endure faith, join together in the unthinking together of the glory, as they the way of suffering and the forgotten what to give thanks. He said the blessing, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all from the drink of it, for this is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory. Therefore, the Lord is to be celebrated in the Lord who will save the passion of his Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven. And as we look forward to the second coming, we offer him thanksgiving this holy community time. Look, we pray, upon the offering of this day, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by his death, and willing to reconcile with you. Grant us peace to emerge by the body and blood of his Son, and fill with the Holy Spirit, that we have one body, one Spirit of God. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your death, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Apostles and Lord of the Martyrs, the Saint James, our patron, with all the saints, and his constant intercession, you and your honor, for unfailing God. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to return in faith and charity to the goodness of his own earth, to your servant, the Francis of Hope, my friend, the entire community of nation, for your love. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family that you have called before you. In your compassion, in the midst of the body, gather to yourself all the utilities that are in you. Are in front, brothers and sisters. And to all who are pleased to bring their passion to this time, with time and measure, be with you. There in the hope of the joy forever, the fullness of the glory, in Christ our Lord, who is to be so under glory.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Gracious and friendly, and our days of thy health and virtue, that we may be free from sin and safe from distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Lord.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus, we thank you for your love, keep silent, and we have to decide. Look not on our sins, but on the face of the church, and graciously grant us peace and unity, according to your will, who live and reign forever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit. I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. cleansing, ever living God, who restored us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ. Can you please give us the fruits of this Easter sanctuary and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving community through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
This is a reminder that next Saturday we will have Mass at 4 p.m. instead of 5. 4 p.m. Mass next Saturday. There is an article in the Volk to speak about our elves. We decided that we were going to move forward for that. The elves have to be a lot of stuff that really needs to be fixed because the original equipment needs like the belt and everything that the people's lifetime. So the cost level is about $26, which is a big cost, but I'm happy to report that these special donations are going to be really close. Yeah, last time I was saying about that, you go to our church, the church that you put on the same bell, that's the secret to the bell, what you need to do, what you want to do, find out the secret. So, take a look at that. But the pre-K graduation is on Wednesday, the 7th spot. Kindergarten Mass at 8:20. Everybody who is supposed to end, all have a program after the Mass in the very center. We still have roses out here for Mother's Day, so you can purchase them for the home or in the week of the year, and then the deceased mother, we encourage all of you to do that as well. And I want to say a special thanks to everyone. We showed up this morning on our birthday, and we had a crazy few people that came in for a part of the flowers. We had a lot of that. And some things that we really needed to talk about that we had to do with this year's birthday. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I would like to just conclude with a special blessing for our mother, for the good and gentle God, we pray in gratitude for our mothers who have joined with you in the wonder of bringing forth your life. We became human with a woman. Grant to all mothers the courage and gain the face to have a certain community that life with the children always give them the strength to love and to be young and to be fair. Give them the faith to support their husband, family, and friends as they care for their physical and spiritual growth of their children. Give them joy and life in their children to sustain them, unify them. And most of all, give them the wisdom to turn to you for help and to be grateful. May Almighty God bless all of them and may God bless you.
Thanks be to God.